Yes, I use economic strength, used effectively but without abuse, has meant much to seafarers. Security, a higher standard of living, a position of respect in their communities. And for those staying ashore a while, there's an SIU school.
My name is Michael Sacco, and I'm president of the Seafarers International Union of North America.
What does a union mean to you? George.
I'd say protection on the job, security. It means the boss can't shove me around.
Anyone else? Benny?
I look at it this way. I see other guys doing things together. I want to be part of it.
Come with me, my love, to the sea of love.
The industry and the union got together and decided that we needed a training facility to upgrade the quality of seamen in the SIU to go to sea. We started out with three different schools in three different areas. Most of them were not in compliance with the Coast Guard, so we decided to consolidate all of the schools, the three schools, and come here to Piney Point to start a training facility with one curriculum, with one goal in mind, and that was to train deck, engine, and steward department people for the maritime industry and upgrade the quality of the people. This was in 1967.
The school was completely different. We had old barracks here that were left over from the Navy. The bungalows where all the trainees stayed. Old wooden shacks, an old wooden hotel for the upgraders.
In 1974, we lived in bungalows up against the back of the school. The hotel wasn't here. It was basically, it used to be a Navy submarine testing facility. So we used all the Naval, it was all the stuff the Naval personnel lived in.
Well, it wasn't much here, you know, like all this today I see is new, you know. When I was here, we had the bungalow, administration building, old hotel, and I seem to take them out here like a boxing ring or something. Then
you'll hear stories from the guys that have been here in years past of how this started out as a small naval base with small bungalows, wooden buildings, and now we have this massive piece of infrastructure that is constantly being updated and maintained. So the physical plant itself is ever evolving. The physical plant itself is growing, okay, to meet the needs and the standards of the industry. And the core of the whole campus really is the spirit of the industry and the spirit of the SIU, which really is the mainstay of the current merchant marine.
They're going to be demonstrating how to get into the life raft from the water.
There's a lady in a turban.
Hold the line.
She does a dance over. She's trying to skin. Having a time. Don't let her go, baby. Treat her fine.
Thousand miles out in the middle of nowhere, they can't call 911. We train them from the ground up how to mitigate any type of fire situation. So basically, some of the stuff we go over with the students is the properties of LNG, because some of the vessels now are powered by it. We go over a lot of the properties, the stored temperatures of the liquid, the dangers of it if for some reason that liquid does leak on the ship.
The school itself, as you know, has a first-class marine firefighting and training school located over on across the creek on a farm. Curriculum is always changing. We base our curriculum upon the needs of the industry. We base our curriculum upon the CFRs, what the Coast Guard mandates are, the federal regulations, and quite frankly, we also base a lot of our curriculum on the needs and wants of our contracted employers to meet their specialized equipment. The school's unique in the sense that we bring men and women from all over the country, and we work them through several weeks of classroom time, then several weeks aboard ship, and then they come back for additional classroom time. Basically, everything's centered around safety, and safety's first and foremost, especially in our industry today. With the equipment getting larger, bigger, faster, we have to be more in tune with safety aspects.
The Freedom Star is critical to our mission here at the school. Whether she's underway or at the dock, the vessel provides for valuable on-hand training and real-time lessons. With this type of learning platform, the school and its instructors are capable of assessing students and granting the assessments mariners need to secure and maintain their endorsements.
In addition to that, we've made major upgrades to our culinary department. There's a new culinary lab with an emphasis, a heavy emphasis, on the culinary arts.
Hi, I'm John. I've been here 20 years. I've trained a lot of chief cooks. They prepare everything from scratch. We don't take anything out of the freezer. My job is to make sure that they know how to take raw materials and turn them into delicious food, and so the crew is happy. And the quality of the food has a huge effect on the morale in the ship. And if the cook's not good, they're not going to like it. If the cook is good and the food is good, people are a lot happier. Right now we're very pleased with what the cooks are doing and the feedback that we're getting from the chief cooks that are going out there and working.
Paul had a vision. Paul could see the ships of the future. They were becoming larger, more complex, more technologically driven. And he realized that the seafarer of the future had to be better educated and better trained, because he knew the technology was coming and he had to prepare his men for that technology. As a result, education and training has become a bedrock in the SIU. This school today at Piney Point is really a legacy of Paul's vision, his drive, his commitment to excellence, and it's a vision that is embraced and expanded upon by Mike Sacco.
Part of their Coast Guard training for ratings and for officer licensing to do practical exercises in a realistic environment, and the simulator provides that for them.
For the last 50 years, this school has been training students for real-life world jobs. Jobs that have union protection, excellent salaries, pension plan, medical plan, and most of all, an entry into the middle class.
The classes I took as an apprentice and the help I received from my instructors and the staff really helped me to adjust to life aboard merchant ships. I'm also really grateful to the school for always staying current with the ever-changing certification requirements for our documents. The fact that we don't have to pay for travel, classes, or boarding, you really can't beat that.
On behalf of myself and the other people in the SIU, captains in my fleet, I just want to thank the Paul Hall Center for just keeping up with all the regulations and always making a class to fill the need so that we can keep up our licenses and the programs. And without the school, and to keep up with all the regulations and keep our paperwork in order, we wouldn't be where we were today. So I wanted to say thank you.
It's always a challenge. Every ship you go on, it's a challenge. You meet new people. You go all over the world. You see how other people live. And I guess if I had something to say about going to sea, I would love to see many people have a chance to go to sea, go to other countries, and see what these other countries have to offer. Because when you come back here to the United States, you're so thankful that you live in a country as great as this, with the type freedoms that we have.
Most of the other countries that I deal with on an international basis, they just go to work at sea. It's their job, they make their living, and they go home. In the U.S., it's a different feel for seafarers. We feel that we're part of something bigger than just going to work finishing up our tour and going home. One, because of our service to the country, and also it allows us, as I said before, to provide rewardingly for our family.
2017 is an exciting year for us. It brings us into our 50th year, our 50th anniversary for the school. That's 50 years of training and excellence. Coming here as a trainee, as I did in the early 90s, gives you a sense of brotherhood, gives you a sense of belonging. That's certainly something that's very unique in this industry.
Some ships are better than others. That's a given in this industry, but the bottom line is we all enjoy what we do, and we know that it's for, in most cases, it's for the betterment of the nation.
Our industry is changing rapidly. Automation is setting in, technology is changing. In order for us in the labor movement, and especially in the SIU, to meet these challenges, we have to make sure we continually upgrade our labor force to keep up with the changing times in the industry. We have here at the school an advisory board. On this advisory board is all of our ship owners. They review our curriculum, and they recommend changes that are taking place in their companies. So in order for them to be competitive and profitable, they have to have workers that go aboard that ship and do a good job, and keep those ships running. And that's the key to all of it. This school is the future of our organization.